One highly anticipated .NET MAUI feature is the .NET MAUI Maps, showing maps in your application. A first version has now been merged in .NET MAUI, so it's about time that we have a first look. And if you stick around until the end of the video, I'm going to share with you a little secret about how you can get started yourself today. If you have been around since Xamarin.Forms, then you know Xamarin.Forms had a separate maps package that allowed you to show a map in your application. On iOS, that would be Apple Maps. On Android, that would be Google Maps, right? So it would show the map that would belong on that platform. You can do all kinds of cool stuff, adding pins, adding polygons, adding all kinds of crazy stuff. So a lot of people were disappointed that the maps were not in the initial version of .NET MAUI. I can totally understand. And now, for .NET 7, we're planning to release .NET MAUI Maps, so it's going to be here. I put out a little tweet, I did a little something on the community tab here on YouTube, and like asking, hey, should I do an early preview version? Because the code has just been merged, it's a first version, we still need to work out some bugs, but we're on track to release this for .NET 7, and I asked, like, hey, should we do a first early preview? And a lot of overwhelming response came in, like, yes, I want to see this early version, so here we are. Now, before we get started, there's a couple of things that are good to know. There are a couple of breaking changes. So we had a lot of properties that were named has zoom enabled, has traffic enabled, and it's kind of like weird with the has, right? The properties that start with has. So and we had, I think, one property that was named is showing user. So that was also inconsistent. So we made that consistent. It's now all called is traffic enabled, is zoom enabled, all that kind of stuff. It starts with is. But another maybe even a little bit bigger change is that we have now Essentials is built into .NET MAUI, right? And Essentials has a location object. For Xamarin.Forms maps, we had a position object. Both do kind of the same thing. They both have a set of coordinates that can point to a location on a map, right? So we decided to get rid of the position element and use the location object that is in Essentials so that you can use the same for both. That will also make it easier to integrate both of these codes, both of these APIs. But that means if you're transitioning from Xamarin.Forms, there is some stuff to get used to. Let me just show you with a little example. Let's dive into Visual Studio. Now, this video is going to be a little bit different than you're used to for me because this demo is completely set up already. I just want to give you an early preview, an early look of what is coming, what it looks like right now. As such, I already prepared the full demo. So here we are in Visual Studio 2022. I also booted up the iOS remote simulator with which you can show the iOS device, the simulator from a Mac that's connected through the network on Windows. Not just because I like to see, like to show you that this also works, but also because when I was preparing this demo on Android, there were a couple of rough edges on the Android version. So right now, iOS seems to be the best version working, and it's also the easiest one because you don't need any API keys or anything. So the first thing we want to do is go over to our Solution Explorer and right-click on our project and say Manage NuGet Packages. Now, here you can see already two NuGet packages. These are not publicly available yet. That's where the secret comes in a little bit, stick till the end. But you will find these whenever you have that set up on your machine. And the one you want to install is microsoft.maui.controls.maps. That has a dependency on this core package, the microsoft.maui.maps. It will pull that in automatically and you're good to go. Notice how here the packet source is set to local downloads. If you don't know how to set up a local NuGet feed, there is a video popping up on the corner of your screen right now, or find it in the video description below. I have a video on that to help you with that. That will come later. Now we've got that set up. Let's go to our, whenever you've installed that, we want to go to our mauiprogram.cs because we now have this new app builder and you want to do use MAUI maps. That's it. That will register the handlers and everything that's needed to set up the maps. Just that one line and you're done initializing basically. So another thing that you want to do is ask the permissions. If you want to use that is showing user, it's going to show a little indicator of where your device actually is. And typically that means if you're holding the device where you are in the world. So you want to add permissions to that. For Android, you can go to like the inside of your MAUI project. You need to go to platforms, Android, and the Android manifest.xml. And you need to, inside of this application, add this metadata. Well, this is actually not the permission. This is the API key that I'm explaining right here. So you also need to get an API key. It's in the documentation for Xamarin.Forms. The documentation for .NET MAUI Maps will come really soon. Go to your Google developer account, get this API key. Don't worry, you hacker persons out there. This one is invalidated by the time you see this, but you need this API key in there. If you don't have it, it will throw an exception on the use MAUI Maps if it doesn't find this key here. But if you want to also show that location, that was what I was actually talking about, you need to do the locations right here. So make sure that you put these in here so that you request the right location. Of course, the same thing for iOS, but now in the info p list. So let's go here with open with XML text editor. And you can see down here that I'm requesting this location permissions with a little descriptive string of why I want to use the permissions. This is the same thing for macOS. The code can be found on GitHub, so make sure that you inspect it there in full detail. So now that we've got that set up, we can actually start implementing the UI. So let's go to our mainpage.xaml. And the first thing you want to do is import this XML namespace. I've called it maps, this can be anything. And you want to look for microsoft.maui.controls.maps. So that has the map control, and now you can start using it with maps and map. We're working on hopefully getting rid of this so that you can just use the map like any other control. But for now, to make sure that it works, do it this way. Also, if you want to use that location inside of XAML, so not the position, the location, you need to add this little namespace right here for the essentials, which lives now under Microsoft MAUI devices.sensors. That's where the location object lives, so that you can declare locations inside of your XAML as well. So now we got this. Now we got this map. I gave it a little name of mappy. Is showing user is true. Is traffic enabled is true. Let's actually just run this on the iOS simulator while I'm talking through this so that we can actually see it in action as well. And here you can set all these kinds of crazy things. So we have a couple of other properties here, right? We have the other thing like is, what do we have more? Is scroll enabled? So if you can actually like scroll to other locations, is visible. If it's visible, yes or no, is zoom enabled? If you can pinch and pan to zoom, actually, the is showing user, is it showing your user location? Is traffic enabled? That will show the traffic information. So it will have little red and orange and green lines whenever you know, if there is a traffic in some kind of street, yes or no. But you can do much, much more. And you can do that both, you can do all of this in code and in XAML, whatever you prefer. But you can do also polygons and lines and make mark different territories on a map. Now, in XAML, it's kind of verbose. You can see it right here. I'll just scroll over it real quickly. You can set different colors inside of like this geopath, so it will draw this thing for you. And you could do all these kinds of things. So this is a lot to take in XAML, but you can also do this from code, which probably make more sense, but you can do this from XAML as well. So lots of options here. Now, the application booted up here on the right. Let me get myself out of the way here. And you can see that it asks for my permission, right? So that's good. It wants to show my permission. Well, let's do it while using the app. That's great. And we're seeing here the wonderful island of Maui, Hawaii. So that's the default location, but you can set the location, of course, whichever it has to show initially. So we can zoom out here a little bit as well. We can go all kinds of ways. You can do pan to zoom here. Just have to hold down that Alt button, the command button, and we can zoom out. And here you can see it's showing our location. We have this little blue dot. That's how iOS shows the location, right? So I think this is in, I don't know, the Apple campus probably. And here, a little bit above, you notice this little black dot. So let's zoom in on that. This is in Seattle, in Redmond to be exact. I think this is the Microsoft campus. And that big blurb of XAML that you just saw is creating this. So you can mark this kind of like orange thing here, the blue thing here, and a line. Maybe this is some kind of road. I don't know. I copied this from the forms documentation. There was a little example, so I just took it from there. But yeah, so this is there. You can do this. And what I didn't show you yet is I added pins. So you can add pins on the map as well. I did that from code. You can do it in XAML as well. But here in code, you can see mappy. So that's the name that I gave it. Pins.add new Microsoft MAUI controls maps pin. You have to give it a label, I think, else it will blow up, which is conveniently something like subscribe to my channel. Maybe you're watching a YouTuber right now that you think, hey, this person deserves a subscribe. Do it now. This is your time. And a little location, right? So we have this location, which is actually really close to me. So we can zoom out a little bit. Zoom, zoom, zoom. And scroll a little bit here. Oh, there we go. There's the pin. This is how iOS shows pins. And we can zoom in, You can click it, it does a little bouncy thingy, which is really nice. Oh, and you can also see here in Cologne, I'm close to Cologne, you can see the traffic information, right? So you can see all these red, there's a lot of traffic right here. You can see the red and the orange. And I can go back here to my XAML. I can say, is traffic enabled? I can say false, and boom, then it all goes away, right? It also works with hot reload, which is really amazing. So set it back to true. You can also choose the map type. So you can do map type satellite. We'll get the satellite image, so the satellite photos. It doesn't work together with is traffic enabled, so we lose that. But if you want to have both, we can set it to hybrid, and you will get the satellite images, but also the streets, and you get back the traffic information here. So you got all kinds of options. Now, you also have all kinds of events and commands, like map clicked. So whenever something is clicked, I think you also get back the location that you actually clicked, the GPS coordinates, and that kind of stuff. So there is lots of things going on. One other thing while I was in the code behind here is I did the request permission. I don't think the map handles the permissions automatically, at least not on Android is what I found. Maybe that's another bug, I don't know. But you can request that because we have Essentials and these permissions APIs built in right now. It probably needs a little bit more code than this to also find the fallback scenarios, but now this is good for my use case. And that is kind of like a really quick overview of how Maps works right now. So that's cool, right? We got lots, tons of options. You can do all these kind of things with maps. Of course, there is crazy other things. I think over the years, a lot of people have requested also the clustering of pins and that kind of stuff. Let us know in the GitHub repository, the .NET MAUI GitHub repository, what else you'd like to see, or better yet, just contribute it to our wonderful project. Now, I promise you a little secret on how to get started with this yourself today. So let's just quickly hop back to the screen share and I'll show you. So here we're back on the screen. I opened a in private browsing session on the Edge browser, and let's go to github.com/.NET/MAUI. Now, the in private is just so you're sure, and I'm sure that I'm not logged into any accounts here, so that you're sure that you can do this as a non-Microsoft employee as well. And then you here in the top bar, if you just go to the landing page, you will see a little red cross here. Typically, it should be a green check mark so that the build has gone through successfully, the continuous integration build. But if you click regardless of the icon that's here, it can also be a yellow dot if something is in progress. If you click it here, you can go in here and you can see all kinds of build pipelines. Now, the one that you want is MAUI public. So look for that, and you can go to details here, and you will get all the details about this build. How many tests has passed? You can see we have 16,000 tests running for each build. So that's really amazing. Zero failed. Good news. And you can scroll down here and you can see view more details on Azure pipelines. It's a bit small, but it's there. And if you go to there, you can inspect this on Azure DevOps, where this is actually running the builds. And you can see here, let me zoom in here a little bit. We have related, and here is published and consumed. This is the build artifact. So each build produces build artifacts. So you can go in here, and this is all the build artifacts that we're producing, which is NuGet packages, which is documentation, which is all kinds of things, logs, whatever. But you want to have this NuGet. And if you're not logged in, if you're logged in, you can view all the files that are in here. If you're not logged in, like you're probably not going to be, then you can only download one of these artifacts as a whole. So it's a big zip file. And you can go here on the way to the right and you can say download artifacts. Whenever you do that, you will get this NuGet package zip. I think I have it here. And inside of that, you will have another NuGet folder, but you will have all the NuGet packages that make up the workload of .NET MAUI. But in there, you will find the Microsoft.MAUI.controls.maps. Make sure that you get the new PKG and not the S and new PKG. And you also want to have the Microsoft.MAUI.maps itself. Move that to a folder, follow that video on how to set up a separate NuGet feed locally from a folder on your device, and you can install the NuGet packages. So shh, don't tell anyone, but this is how you can get started with .NET MAUI Maps today. Now that you know that, I would definitely encourage you to get started with this package, this early access package. But do keep in mind, this is very early preview bits, right? This is just merged into the code base, but this allows you to get started with it. It works with the current version of .NET MAUI, at least currently. But remind, if you are going to logbox for this on the repository, please come with high quality bug reports. You know, do your best to tell us what is going on so that we can fix this. And whenever you report importing now, we can make sure that you don't have to see that whenever .NET 7 comes and we're actually launching the .NET MAUI maps, right? So you're doing yourself a favor basically by making this more stable for when this actually comes available. But keep in mind, it has rough edges right now. So just make sure to be nice, which is something that you always should do in your bug reports. But Gerald, you didn't mention anything about Windows. Well, no. Because, you know, for .NET MAUI, we're building on top of WinUI, and WinUI doesn't have a map control yet. So we've built something with a web view that loads like Bing Maps, but we're not really sure if that's something that we want to maintain or if we want to wait for WinUI to come up with something. So Windows is kind of in limbo right now. It's not implemented. We're thinking about maybe distributing it through the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. So stay tuned for the Windows support. And again, let me know down in the comments if you are that person that is interested in the Windows version so we can see if we can work with that basically. I hope this was very beneficial to you, this early look on maps. Let me know what you think down in the comments. Let me know what you think, what feature of the maps are you want me to zoom in on. So maybe you want to see more about the polygons, the pins, custom pins, you name it. I can make videos about all of that. Please let me know then down in the comments about that as well. Don't forget to like this video if you've actually liked it, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already, and check here for this playlist where there is more wonderful .NET MAUI content. Maybe this video right here is very suitable for you, and right here you can have that button so that you can very easily subscribe to my channel. See you for the next one.